What age were you when you realized it was possible to get fat?
Well, I was like a chubbier kid. So
the answer is 3, Brian. Thank you for bringing that up.
Well, it's weird because like I was a fatter, I was a chubbier kid, and I kind of got my stepdad used to make fun of me a little bit for being a fatter kid than my brother. And then
how does a stepdad make that joke? It'd be like, you know, why'd y'all run upstairs? If Justin can make it up,
you fat piece of shit asshole.
Well, I would never love like my own son. He's more fat than man now, twisted and evil.
Twisted and blubbery.
Your stepdad talks in Star Wars analogies. So, I mean, what constitutes a joke indicating the size discrepancy?
Like, you know, like doing a cannonball into the pool and like, oh, you're going to, you know, push all the water out of the pool, you fat fuck piece of shit asshole cunt. Glad I didn't father you, you fucking worthless turd fucker asshole. I might be remembering things a little different than how they went. You ever worry about, and then to sidetrack, but like, you ever worry that like, there are just large swaths of history that could have just been drastically different from like two people remembering it like a different way?
Oh, dude, let me tell you, man, one of the greatest realizations of my entire life was that all memory is bullshit. Both the people who are good at convincing you that they remember it right and the people who aren't so sure, all of them are equally wrong.
Like, this is one of the things, like, if you had, like, a time machine, you go back in time and you realize that, like, Abe Lincoln was Asian, and you're like, what the fuck? How did we miss that?
You know what? If I had a time machine, I'd go back and I'd be like, see, I told you it was Pitfall, not Jungle Search. Suck it.
Okay, so you're just going to go back and solve petty arguments that you've had? Exactly. Oh, yeah, really? And you get in your own TARDIS, and you just take them back. And it's like the same big, like, you fucking fade into your living room. The young Brian Brushwood is terrified, screaming and yelling. And then you just walk out. It's total pandemonium and chaos. Your parents are going nuts. You and your friend from, like, you know, you're 8 years old, they're screaming. You just walk over to the console and you pull out the cartridge. You're just like, told ya. Pitfall, fucker. You just get right back into the TARDIS. It's the most mundane, shitty adventure that you can have.
I would like to think that the Lords of Gallifrey had the common sense to create a separate device called the Petty TARDIS, which is like a lesser version of the TARDIS that, in fact, you can't
I think it's the re-TARDIS.
Yes. That's because you're going back to places you've already been, so you have to revisit these places. How will we go back to this point in the past to settle this argument? Let's take the retardists and off you go, right?
And then, like, the Doctor Who theme to these episodes are the same Doctor Who theme, but it's the guys, like, doing, like, the hand fart music, like... Oh my god, I would actually just immediately start ejaculating if you actually did the Doctor Who thing hand farts right now.
Even if it was a trick, even if like somehow I manufactured this conversation and you brought it up, and all of a sudden
unlike
you
a time
rocking.
Traveler, you knew this was coming, and you had trained for 30 years.
You're like, how did I know? And it's like I panned the camera over, I'm like, I took the retardus back here for this moment.
So if the TARDIS is the police box, what is the retardus? What is does it look like?
You know what? The retardus is an actual phone booth, which is what we all thought the police box was growing up. But it's just an actual phone booth. But like everyone looking at it is so dumb, they don't understand that that there's a difference between a police box and a phone booth. Hey, we were talking about getting fat. Talking about...
So anyway, all right. So fatness, I was fat up until like the age of 8 or 9. And that's like fat for me. Like, I know there's other motherfuckers who are like, yeah, boy, yeah, you fucking had an extra fucking 15 pounds. Eat a bag of shit, you fucker.
Yeah. Hey, like, fuck you, man. You could see your dick.
But I was chubbier as a kid. Then I hit a growth spurt. And then it was pretty much up until post college that I like all of a sudden, like having a diet that nearly strictly consisted of
booze,
chicken wings, coffee, and beer when I got like the year that I got out of college. And like you just have that awkward like, I'm an adult now, I pay bills, and then you're like, but you're still living like you did in college. I like kind of like looked in the mirror and I'm like, well, I am definitely 179 pounds when that is normally not what I am.
Like,
and I had like,
what's your I'm okay with this weight number, and what's your like this is where I belong number?
I would probably say like 160 I should be hovering around, and I'm at like 165, 66 now.
I like for years, I think when I first started paying attention was shortly after college, and I kept weighing 137, which I'm a short guy. I tell people I'm 5'7", but I'm like 5'6". I'm nothing. But yes. Bonnie, like, I was like, well, I used to be so svelte, and Bonnie's just like, scrawny. You were scrawny. You are a horrific vision. You are a skeleton with lace laid over it.
That's actually, that would be like how, like, an Indian tribe that you eradicated would describe you. And then over the hill, the skeleton made of lace came.